Morning students, in the last video we have already discussed about elementary operations. Okay, in the last video we have already discussed how to find the inverse of matrix by using elementary operations. It may be row operation or maybe column operations. Okay, there are some problems we do today by using an elementary row operation and elementary column operations. Okay, let's start. Before going to this topic, again I remind you that there are three properties of elementary row operation or column operation. Okay, the first property is our interchange property. We can interchange any row with other row. Okay, that is Ri can be interchanged with Rj, the first property. Okay, for row. Okay, for row operation, that is Ri can be interchanged with Rj, first property. Property number two, we can multiply any scalar with any row. Okay, that is if we write Ri, then we can write Ri tends to some k into Ri. Okay, that means students, we can multiply any scalar with any row. Okay, next property, property number three, Ri can be written as Ri with addition with some scalar multiple of Rj. Okay students, means what? Here look, Ri can be interchanged, that means Ri is changed. How? The Ri is addition with some scalar multiple of Rj, that means ith row is changed with some addition with jth row of some scalar multiple. Clear? So here our three property by using row operations. Similarly for column operation also, there is three property that are for column operation. Point one is here Ri is interchanged with Rj. Similarly, Ci is interchanged with Cj. First one, here Ri changes to k into Ri. So here Ci changes to some k into Ci. Okay, here Ri changes to Ri plus k into Rj. So here Ci interchanges to Ci plus k into Cj. Clear students, these are property of row operation and column operation. Clear? Now come to our question. So first question is, let question number one. Suppose students, A equal to, let us take a 4 minus 2 3 1 4 minus 2 3 1 A 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, so this is our question, that A equal to 4 minus 2 3 1, which is a 2 by 2 matrix. The question is, find the inverse of matrix by using elementary operations. Suppose students, here we apply row operation first. Okay, we know that when we use row operation, at first we write A equal to Ai. A equal to Ai. Okay, A equal to Ai. Now students, in row operation it is actually A equal to Ia. Okay, Ia. In column operation it is A equal to Ai. Okay, so here we put first A equal to this value, that means 4 minus 2 3 1 matrix. This equal to the I value means what? I means what? Identity matrix. Identity matrix means 1 0 0 1 matrix. Okay, now A will be same. The question is 4 minus 2 3 1 and here I equal to 1 0 0 1. Okay, we have to convert this matrix into I. Okay, that means students, we have to convert this A matrix to I. When you convert A matrix to I, then same property will be applied for this one. Then this I matrix will be converted to, suppose B. Okay, then students, here A into B equal to I. We know that if AB equal to I, that means friends, B equal to A inverse or A equal to B inverse. Okay, so here first we have to convert this matrix A into I. When you convert A into I, the same property will be applied for this one. Then the matrix I will be converted to B. Okay, that means this matrix inverse will be fine. Okay, now let's start. So students, our aim is to find I or to convert this matrix into I. I means what? 1, 0, 0, 1. Okay, we have to convert this matrix into this matrix. Okay, to apply row operation, there are three properties. These three properties. Okay, now first our aim is to convert this one 4A11 plus 4 to 1. So students, here the value is 4, here 3. If I apply row operation, row operation's first property. The third property. Okay. Third property is any row can be changed by applying some linear combination of these two. That means IRI plus some scalar multiple with RJ. Okay. Suppose here I apply row operation. Row 1 will be changed, friends. So row 1 tends to, that means row 1 will change. Row 1 minus row 2. Clear? That means, friends, 4 minus 3, the value is 1, which we require. Okay. So property is R1 tends to R1 minus R2. Okay. Then this matrix will be 4, that means row 1 tends to row 1 minus row 2. Row 1 minus row 2, 4 minus 3, the value is 1. Minus 2, minus 1. Row 1 means this one is row 1. Minus 2, minus 1, minus 3. And students, row 2 will be same. So 3, 1 will be fixed. Now same property will be applied for this one. It's equal to 1 minus 0, the value is 1. 0 minus 1, the value is minus 1. Here the second row will be same. So 0, 1 matrix. Clear? Now again, when we convert students, here we already converted to what? A11 plus will be 1, which I declared. Okay, now we have to convert this value, or we have to find this value, that is 1. A21 plus is here 3. So we have to convert it to 0. Okay, as the value is 3, if I write row 2 tends to row 2 means 3 minus 3 into row 1. Row 2 tends to row 2 means 3 students. 3 minus 3 into row 1. Here's 3, 1. Okay, so 3 minus 3 into 1, 3. The value will be 0. Okay, if I apply this one, then what happened? The row 1 will be same because row 2 is same. Okay, so row 1 remains same. So 1 here minus 3. Okay, row 2 will be changed. So row 2 tends to row 2 minus 3 into row 1. 3 minus 3 into 1. The value is 0. Here 1 minus 3 into 3 minus 3. So here 1. Okay, minus of minus plus 9. So value is 10. I think it should be plus 10. Okay. Now same property will be applied for this one. Okay. So here the rho 2 will be changed. That means rho 1 will be fixed. 1 root minus 1. A is here. 0 minus 3. The value is minus 3. 1 minus of minus plus 3. Okay. 1 minus of minus means plus 3. So 1 plus 3 the value is 4. So the matrix is 1 minus 3, 0, 10. Left hand side. Now we have to convert what? Here students, 1 and 0 already put out. Now we have to convert this to 10 into 1. Okay. So we have to find 1, 0, 0, 1. These two already found out. Okay. Now our aim is to convert 10 into 1. Okay. So here 10 is in row 2. Okay. If I apply property, property number suppose 2. Property number 2. The property is Ri can be written as some k or scalar multiple of Ri. That means students, here 10 is there. Okay. So I can write rho 2 changes to 1 by 10 into rho 2. Rho 2 will be changed by applying this property. Rho 2 tends to rho 2 into 1 by 10. 1 by 10 what happened? If I multiply 1 by 10 with rho 2, then this one will be 1. Okay. Which I require. Okay, students. So the matrix will be, here rho 1 will be fixed. So 1 minus 3. Okay, 0. 0 will be multiplied with 1 by 10. The value is 0. And when 10 is multiplied with 1 by 10, the value will be 1. Okay. This is equal to, again here, rho 1 will be fixed. So 1 minus 1. Okay. Now rho 2 will be changed. Minus 3 into 1 by 10. The value is minus 3 by 10. And 4 by 10, here it is 4 by 10, again A is here. Okay students, now we have to convert the students. So 1 find out here, 0 also find out, now 1 also find out. The last part is our 0. We have to convert this value, this value into 0. Okay, here the value is minus 3. So if I write the property, here the row 1, so row 1 will be changed. Row 1 means what? The value is minus 3, that is row 1. Okay, row 1. If I subtract some value from this one, the answer will not be 0. Okay, if I write row 1 plus, if I addition with this one, okay, with 3 into row 2, that means what? Minus 3 is here, plus 3 into 1, the value is 3. Minus 3 plus 3, the value is 0. Okay. What I want? I want. Okay. So, I apply property R1 tends to R1 plus 3 into R2. Clear? Now, the matrix will be, here row 1 will be changed. So, here 0, there is no change. So, 1 minus 3 plus 3, the value is 0. Here the row 2 will be same. It's equal to row 1 will be changed. So 1 plus of this one. Okay. Plus 3 into this one. Plus of 3 will means what? 1. Here R1 is 1. Here the value is minus 9 by 10. Okay. 10 minus 9 by 10. That means value is 1 by 10. Okay. Then similarly minus 1. Okay. Minus 1 plus 3 into 4 by 10. That means 12 by 10. Okay. The value will be 2 by 10. 2 by 10. Okay. So, row 2 remains same. So, minus 3 by 10. And here is 4 by 10 into A. Okay. The answer is, this is equal to, we can write 1, 0, 0, 1. This is equal to here 1 by 10, it is 1 by 5, it is minus 3 by 10, and the value is 2 by 10. 2 by 5, right?
So students, here the A inverse matrix will be find out, and the value is 1 by 10, 1 by 5, minus 3 by 10, 2 by 5. Okay, this is our A inverse. Okay, now students, there is another question. A equal to 3 minus 2, 3, 2, 1 minus 1, 4 minus 3, 2. It is a 3 by 3 matrix. Okay. Now we have to find the inverse of this matrix. Suppose by using column operation. Let's do it with the column operation. Okay. That means column property is the other. This 3 property can be applied. The column operation. Okay. Now, we know that for column operation we write A equal to AI. Okay, here we put this value left hand side, this one will be 3 minus 2, 3 is 2, 1 minus 1 is 4 minus 3, 2. This equal to A into I means what? Here 3 by 3 matrix. So must be identity matrix will be 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 1. Okay. Now again same thing. We have to convert first this diagonal element into 1. Okay. Then if I first convert this value for A 1 1 plus will be 1, then we have to convert these two term will be 0. Similarly, then in the next step, first we have to convert this one will be 1, then these two term will be 0, and in the last step we have to convert this term into 1, then these two term will be 0. This is our process. Okay, so first we have to convert this value 3 into 1. Okay. Here the value is 3, here 2. So easily we can write column, we use column operation. So here value is minus 3, minus 2 is there. So if I apply column 1 tends to, or column 1 will be changed. Column 1 is here 3. If I add column 1 with column 2, 3 minus 2, the value will be 1. So column 1 plus column 2. Okay. Then what happened? The value will be 3 minus 2, the value is 1. 2 plus 1, the value is 3. 4 minus 3, the value is 1. Okay, here given value will be same. Minus 3, 1, minus 3 is 3, minus 1, 2. Okay, again same property will be applied for this one. So A into this one will be column 1 will be changed. So 1 plus C2, 0, 1, 0 plus 1, 1, they have 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. Okay, now we have to convert these two terms into 0. That means students, if I apply a property, that is column 2, then it is column 2, the value is minus 2. If I apply column 2 tends to column 2, that means minus 2 plus 2 into column 1. 2 into column 1 means plus 2. The value will be 0. Similarly, if I apply for this one, column 3 tends to column 3 minus. If the value is minus 2, that's why we add 2 into C1. If the value is plus 3, so we have to subtract from this one. The value is 3 into column 1. Okay, if I apply this one for the matrix, the value will be what? The value will be column 2 and column 3 will be changed. So column 1 remains same. Column 1 is 1, 3, 1. Okay, column 2 tends to column 2 plus 2 into column 1. So the value is 0. Okay, so here 1 plus 2 into 3, the value is 6 plus 1, 7. Here minus 3
plus 2 into, sorry, minus 3 plus 2 into 1, the value is minus 1, okay. Now, similarly, for column 3 tends to column 3 minus 3 into column 1, 3 minus 3, the value is 0. Here, minus 1 minus 9, okay, minus 1 minus 9, the value is minus 10. Here, 2 minus 3, the value is minus 1. Okay, this equal to A into column 1 will be same strength, because as the property is there, so we have to apply this property for this one also. Okay, so column 1 remains same, 1, 1, 0. Column 2 tends to column 2 plus 2 into column 1, 2 into column 1, that means 0 plus 2 into 1, the value is 2, 1 plus 2 into 1, the value is 3, 0 plus 0. Okay, now column 3 tends to column 3 minus 3 into column 1. So 0 minus 3, the value is minus 3. Here 0 minus 3, again, the value is minus 3. Okay, 1 minus 0, the value is 1. Okay, students, now here the first one is find out. 1, 0, 0 is already found out. Now you have to convert this one into 1. Okay, main row, main diagonal. So this one will be 1. So it will be 1. So students, if I apply column 2 minus if I apply C2 tends to 1 by 7 into C2, 1 by 7 into C2, then this will be 1 by property number, I think, 2. Okay, CI tends to K into CA. If I apply 1 by 7, then this will be 1. So the matrix will be 1, 3, 1, this one, and this one is 0, 1 by 7, 0, the value is 1, here the value is minus 1 by 7, again this one is fixed, 0, minus 10, minus 1, okay, it's equal to A into, the value is 1, 1, 0, and column 2 will be changed, so this value is 2 by 7, this one is 3 by 7, okay, and this one is 0. Now this one is 7 minus 3 minus 3 1. Okay students, now we have to convert this 2 to 0. Okay, if I apply for column 1, okay, this one will be 0. Column 1 tends to column 1 means what? 3 minus 3 is equal. So minus 3 into column 2, 0. Now column 3 tends to column 3. Column 3 means what? Minus 10. So we have to add plus 10. So if I write plus 10 into column 2, the value will be 10. This one also 0. Okay. Now the matrix will be column 1 changes to 1 is with the column 2. So value is 0. So remains same. 3 minus 3, the value is 0. It's 1 minus 3 by 7. Okay, it's 1 minus, minus of minus, plus regular. Okay, 1 plus 3 by 7. The 1 plus 3 by 7, the value is 10 by 7. 10 by 7, you have to calculate in yourself. Okay, now column 2 remains same because there column 1 and column 3 is changed. So column 2 remains same. 0, 1 minus 1 by 7. Okay, now column 3 will be changed, so column 3 equal to column 3 plus 10 into column, so this will be 0, this one is 0, and this one is minus 1 plus minus 10 by 7, minus 1 minus 10 by 7, okay, minus 1 minus 1 minus 10 by 7, the value is minus 17 by
7. Okay, minus 17 by 7. Here the same property will be applied for this one, and the answer will be, okay, the answer will be, and the answer will be this one. Okay, note it down. Now, the last step. Here the main diagonal 1, 1, find out, and given value will be 0. Over now, we have to convert this one to 1, and this 2 will be 0. Then, if I apply a property, that column 3, okay, column 3 tends to, if minus 7 by 17 into column 3, into minus 7 by 17, then this one will be 1. Okay, then the matrix will be column 1, column 2 remains same. So 1, 0, 10 by 7 is 0, 1, minus 1 by 7 is 0, 0, and so is 1. Okay, and same property will be applied for this one. So A into, so again same, so 1 by 7 is minus 2 by 7 is 0. 2 by 7 is 3 by 7 is 0. Okay, and this one is minus 1 by 7. Here minus 7 by the property is minus 17 by 7, so minus 17. So minus 1 by 7, here minus 7 by 17. The value is 1 by 17. 9 by 7, here minus 7 by 17. So the value is minus 9 by 17. 1, here the value is minus 7 by 17. Okay? Clear? Now, if I apply for this property, okay, this one will be 0. So if I apply for column 1, column 1 tends to, column 1 means 10 by 7 minus, okay, 10 by 7 into column 3. Okay, this will be 0. Similarly, if I apply for column 2, column 2 tends to column 2, that means minus 1 by 7 plus 1 by 7 into column 3. This one will be 0. Then the matrix will be 1, 0, 10 by 7. Okay, it means 0 actually. This one is 0. This one will be 0. And here 0, 1, this one is 0, and the value is 0, 0, 1, this matrix is equal to, if I apply again the same property for this one, okay, then it will be, then the answer will be this one, okay, you can count it, okay, the answer will be this one, and now the A inverse matrix will be this one, 1 by 17. 8 by 17, 10 by 17, okay, and 5 by 17 is 6 by 17, minus 1 by 17 is 1 by 7, okay, minus 9 by 17 is minus 7 by 7. Okay, here the answer is A inverse. Okay, pause the video, write it down. Okay. If you have any doubt, then write on the comment section. Thank you. Yeah.